Now we'll discuss the analysis of collision of a hydrogenic atom with another atom or particle. Let's consider a situation in which we are given with a hydrogen-like atom on which another atom, which can be a hydrogen-like atom or a neutron or any other particle, is incident onto it with the speed v. So its mass is m1 and that of the hydrogenic atom is considered to be m2. And for analysis, let us consider initially this particle is at rest. So when the incident particle is coming and it will collide head on with the hydrogenic atom, it depends on its initial kinetic energy Ki, which is half m1 v square, whether it will be able to excite this hydrogenic atom to any higher orbit or not. Now in this situation, when it will strike, the two will move further after collision, and from this kinetic energy, some energy can be extracted for excitation of this hydrogenic atom from initially, say if it is in ground state, then 1 to 2 or 1 to 3 or 1 to 4 and so on in any state. Now in this situation, the maximum energy will be absorbed by the hydrogen atom only when the collision is considered to be perfectly inelastic. That is the state when maximum kinetic energy loss takes place. Here if we consider the collision is perfectly inelastic and the two particles after collision are moving together with the speed v final, then in this state we know the loss in kinetic energy is maximum, which can be absorbed by the hydrogen atom for its excitation. Here momentum must always be conserved as no external force is acting. So here we can write m1v is equals to m1 plus m2 multiplied by v final, and in this situation the final kinetic energy in the case will be half m1 plus m2 multiplied by v final square. So in this situation we can calculate maximum kinetic energy loss in this particular situation. Delta k we can write as ki minus kf. Here we can say, by considering collision to be perfectly inelastic, we can calculate maximum loss and kinetic energy, that is delta k max, and any fraction of this energy can be absorbed for excitation of electron. So here we can say, in a particular situation, excitation energy is known for 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4 and so on. Then we can always write, whichever energies are less than this maximum kinetic energy, all possible transition may exist. And after that, corresponding velocities of hydrogen and the incident particle can be calculated. Like we can use, if after a collision the two are moving with different speeds, say v1 final and v2 final for the two particles, then we can use by momentum conservation m1v is equals to m1v1 final plus m2v2 final, and we can write initial kinetic energy minus delta E for excitation, which is absorbed by the hydrogen atom, which must be less than this delta K max which we have calculated earlier, and the remaining energy must be left in form of final kinetic energies of the two particles so that the momentum will remain conserved. So this will be half m1 v1 final square plus half m2 v2 final square, and solving these two equations we can calculate the value of v1 final and v2 final. In a specific situation, if more than one collisions are possible, then all possible values of final velocities of the colliding particles can be calculated.